was just so excited to get moved in here, and I think it just all went to my head.
Hold on tight.
I know I've wanted this move for a while now, but I'm seriously so stressed out. Like, it's not even funny. Like, I'm so stressed out that I just want to cry right now. And it's not even that I'm just stressed out about, you know, living with the baby. It's like a ton of things. Like, it took so long to move today. We didn't get done until 9:30. And I know I didn't help them, you know, majority of the day, but I still helped for a few hours. And then we just got so much stuff, and it's like giving me anxiety right now. There's just so much stuff. And now I have to worry about finding a place for it and organizing it, and I pretty much have to do it just by myself because, you know, Harlan's gonna ask me with every single item, where does this go? Where should this go? Where does this go? So I'm just gonna have to do it all myself. And I'm gonna show you here in a second just how overwhelming this is going to be for me. It's Kenley's room so far. Like, it looks decent. Obviously, I gotta get a crib put away and then put her books away and stuff, but it looks decent. This does not. This is what's really bothering me. This is our living area. Like, we're supposed to be having this open space and living in it. And we can't. Like, I don't even know what half of this stuff is. I don't even know where to put it. And, like, look at our carpets. Look at this. And then, like, look at our freaking bedroom. This is just so insane to me. And not only is our carpets, like, ruined, so this is the playroom, so, like, this looks good, right? This is good. But look at this. And then look at our fridge. This is all we have. I don't know. It's just, like, really getting to me, guys. It's really getting to me. Oh, my gosh. And I know it's, like, not our fault, but now our carpet is, like, so ruined, and it's 10 o'clock at night. Kenley's still not in bed, and her crib's not even put together, and I don't even know how to do it, and she's tired, and she's crying over everything, so that's not helping, and our bedroom is an awful mess because of so much clothes that I have. And it makes me feel like a horrible person that I just even have that much stuff. We don't have any food because we didn't get to go shopping today. So we have, like, barely anything even in the fridge. I have to finish out this week at my job. So I have to leave, like, over an hour earlier than what I usually do so that I can get to work on time. Our apartment's cold, and like I said, the carpets are destroyed, so now I have to figure out how to, like, clean that so that, you know, it doesn't get stained and it's even harder to get out. Or we get fined for that. I just wanna, you know, like, take a shower or a bath or whatever, and I still have to give Kinley a bath because she hasn't had a bath for 3 days. And, you know, I go to give her a bath, and we don't have a freaking drain stopper, so now Harlan has to run out to the store at 10 o'clock at night and get one of those, and we can't take a shower because we bought the shower curtains, but we didn't get the shower rings, so now we can't do either of those. I don't know how you parents move with multiple children, or even just move on your own. I don't know how you do it, because this is literally stressing me out so bad right now. Like, I cannot even handle it right now. And I keep yelling at Harlan, and I don't mean to. It's just, he just doesn't understand how aggravated I am right now. And he just doesn't understand, you know, how overwhelming this is for me. Because like I said, he's hardly even, probably even gonna help, because he's not gonna know where to put anything. So the only room right now that even looks remotely decent is Kenley's bedroom and the playroom, because the playroom has like two things in it, and her bedroom looks kind of put together, but like I said, I don't know how to put the crib together. And like my mom showed me, but it's really difficult because the little screw thing they had to put through, and you have to match it up with the right thing, and we can't even put it together tonight. So what we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to put our mattress on the floor in our room, and then put Kenley's crib mattress up next to it so she can have her own place and Harlan doesn't have to sleep on the floor. Then we also, you know, we took my parents' old washer, but guess what? We can't use it because we need to get all these new things for it before we can even use it. And he even knows when that's gonna be. And I hate to like be like this and, you know, show you guys, you know, how I'm feeling right now, but you know, this is me, this is real, this is reality, this is what's going on. And I feel like I said like a million things right now, and it probably just doesn't even make any sense, but it makes sense to me. I mean, you guys aren't in my shoes right now, or maybe you have been. So if you've ever been in my shoes before, please let me know so I don't feel like I'm alone, because this is seriously like torturing me inside. It's really bothering me. Well, I guess thanks for tuning into my TED Talk. I hope this, you know, gets over with really soon, because like I said, it's just like destroying me mentally and physically right now. I just hope I can get it all put away this week. Well, next week after I leave Chipotle, we can find a home for all of this crap that we have. And then it can actually feel like a home. Alright, that's all for today. I'm sorry that I'm being such a Debbie Downer after I've been like, you know, building this up about how excited I was, and now I'm just like ruining the mood. But like I said, this is me, this is real, this is my vulnerability coming out, and sometimes you just need to be vulnerable to feel human, to feel sane. I just hope some of you can reach out to me and, like I said, make me feel like I'm not alone, because I can really use the support right now. All right, well, see you guys.